Hello, it's Sayori, and it's May 15th, 2016, 8 p.m. at my house. My podcast is about Cambodian culture in Philadelphia, which includes information of when Cambodians started coming to Philadelphia, as well how the community has changed from an historic Irish community to an Asian community. I will also include places where a lot of Cambodians usually go to, or that has something to do with Cambodian culture and the history of some of those places in Philly as well. There's a Cambodian Association of Greater Philadelphia, and it's located on North 5th Street, and it's an association that has three components, which are Cambodian language and history, classical Cambodian dance, and modern dance, which has hip-hop and break dancing. This association was established in 1979 after the time of the Killing Fields, which is also known as the Khmer Rouge, or the Cambodian-Vietnamese War that lasted from 1975 to 1979. And about 3 million Cambodians died from starvation, disease, or have been killed by the Vietnamese or was executed under the Cambodian's dictator Pol Pot. After the war, it's estimated that about 5,000 refugees from Cambodia came to Philadelphia. This was the start of the Cambodian culture in Philly. Over the years, the Asian community in Philadelphia was growing. In 1986, the Khmer Palai Buddhist Monastery Temple opened its gates. The Buddhist temple is located on 19143-2303 South Eastern Street in Southwest Philly. Their arrival has changed from South Philly from its historic Irish-American roots to an Asian community. When the Buddhists arrived, they began following traditions from Jewish and Christian communities by making their temple into a whole central worship area, as well as investing money and energy into their rundown neighborhoods. The temple's visitors are mostly from Cambodian and Vietnamese descent, and about 2,000 to 3,000 people visit on New Year's, which is usually on April 13th or 14th. The gates for the Khmer Palai Buddhist Monastery Temple are not only open for Cambodians, but as other people as well. 17 years later, another temple has opened its gates. This temple is the Pre-Buddha Rinzai Temple, and it is located on 2400 South 6th Street, and has been here since 2003. The chief monk, Muni Ratana, saw that the Cambodian community needed a support place where everyone can come together and maintain their culture and religion. This temple was built without funds or grants from the government, as Muni wanted the temples to look similar to the ones in Cambodia. He also said in an interview that after Cambodia began transitioning toward a democracy in 1993, Cambodians in South Philly began to sponsor relatives back home to come live here, where it was easier to find a job, providing a second wave of Cambodian immigration. He also said that Cambodians have been through the killing fields. They lost everything. The temple is a place to build again their hope, to make them happy to live in a community. But there are not only temples that represents Cambodian culture here in Philadelphia, but there is an art gallery that has been here since 2006. The Khmer Art Gallery is located on North 11th Street in Callow Hill. The founders of this gallery is Bob and Bona Nieng Winstein. In 2003, Bob and Bona Nieng Winstein, and along with their 4.5-year-old son, took a trip to Cambodia and was inspired by the country's unique art. And after 3 years of making, the gallery opens. The goal of the gallery is for others, mostly other Cambodians, to have a connection and to relate to the artwork. Also, they want to bring people together. The gallery has different types of artwork, such as stone statues, copper tables, urns, paintings, carvings, scarves, and wood carvings that was handpicked from Cambodia. It represents the diverse art and culture of the country. Today, there's a place that my family and friends go quite often. This place is called Little Cambodia, which is kind of like a small Cambodian town that is located on 6th and 7th Street between Morris and Oregon in South Philadelphia. Although, people do call this place Cambodian Town because of the increase of Cambodian culture and immigrants in Philadelphia. The area is surrounded with a Khmer restaurants, groceries, clothing and jewelry stores, hair salons, and etc. Sometimes there is even street food. Moving on, there were many previous events that has happened here, such as back in April 21st, 1990, Cambodians celebrated a belated Cambodian New Year for the first time in South Philly. At that time, a lot of people went to celebrate this holiday, and there was traditional line dances, cooking demonstrations, and many other things. People also brought food to share with others. About 900 people celebrated this citywide holiday. There are other places of Philadelphia with Cambodian culture, such as the Franklin D. Roosevelt Park, which has vendors that sell Cambodian food and other things. Sometimes, there is a bubble tea truck there that is called Bubba & Co. that is owned by Cambodians. With that being said, they sell frappes, shaved ice with jelly fruit and condensed milk, smoothies, bubble tea, and as well as sugarcane drinks. Also, they have recently opened their outdoor cafe that is located on 19148 West 600 Moyamensing Avenue. There are a few Cambodian restaurants in Philadelphia, such as Khmer Street Basil, that is located on 1801 South 6th Street. Another restaurant that I know is called I Heart Cambodia, and it's located on 2207 South 7th Street, as well as Khmer Kitchen, which is located on 1700 South 6th Street. And finally, New Phnom Penh, that is located on 2301 South 7th Street. Today, Philadelphia has the fourth largest population of Cambodians in the country. There are about 20,000 Cambodians here in Philadelphia. The Asian community in Philly is growing, especially the Cambodian community. There are many restaurants, stores, and other places like temples that Cambodians enjoy going to, and these places are for other people to enjoy with us as well. Well, that's the end of my podcast about Cambodian culture in Philadelphia.